Hi and welcome to ISBI. Today I'm gonna make a circle cutting jig for my small bandsaw. I start by cutting phenolic coated plywood to size. The phenolic coating are on both sides of the plywood. This piece will be the base plate of the jig. Next, I will cut a T-slot in the base plate, so I set up my router table. Because this T-slot goes not completely through, I make a mark on the fence so I know when to stop. In this T-slot should fit a T-track. Because the height of the T-track is bigger than the height of the T-slot, I have to raise the router bit slightly and make another pass. After this second pass, the T-track fits perfectly. Here I dismantle the bandsaw table because I have to cut it slightly smaller. Otherwise the jig would not fit on the table. I made this table right after I bought this bandsaw because the original table was made out of sheet metal and was very unstable. Then I cut two strips out of the same phenolic coated plywood as before. These two strips will be the side guides of the jig. I cut these two strips to the proper length, and I shorten the cutoff piece of the table because this piece will be the stop of the jig. Here I send a slight angle on each of the side guides. This angle will help to slide the jig easily over the bandsaw table later. Then I use the table of the bandsaw to space the side guides in the right distance. I use my marking jig to mark the points for the screws. I screw the side guides to the base plate with the phenolic coating against the bandsaw table. In this way, the jig can slide without any friction. Next, I screw the table back to the bandsaw. To be able to fix the T-track in its position, I drill a hole from underneath in the base plate. This hole has to be exactly in the middle of the T-slot. The T-track I use is self-made. I bought an aluminum tube with a rectangular shape that fits perfectly to an M6 hex screw head. Then I used a metal router bit to cut a slit on one side of the tube. As the pivot point of the circle cutting jig, I use a small screw. So I mark the center point of the hole to the T-track, and I draw a round shape with the help of a washer to the T-track as well. Before I drill the hole, I sand the T-track to this rounded shape on the disc sander. After that, I use a file to take away the sanding burrs. Here I drill the hole for the pivot screw and use a bigger drill bit to make a countersink from the inside of the T-track. To secure the screw to the T-track, I use a washer and a stop nut. Next, I shorten the T-track with a handsaw. To fix the T-track in its position, I use a wing nut with a plastic head. For some strange reason, the wing screws are cheaper than the wing nuts. So I bought a long time ago a bunch of these wing screws, and when I need a wing nut, I replace the screw with a nut. It's very easy to do, and as a bonus, I have a screw left over which I can use for other projects. To be able to put the hex screw in the T-track, I have to drill a hole from the top of the base plate, which is bigger than the screw head. Here you can see the situation with the screw in the T-track. If the wing nut is loose, I can slide the T-track, and when I tighten the wing nut, the T-track is locked and can't slide at all. Time to make the cut in the base plate. Therefore, I slide the jig over the table until the middle of the T-track is in line with the tooth ground of the saw blade. Then I set the stop strip against the table and clamp it in its position to the jig. I take the T-track out, slide the jig out, lay the jig upside down on the table saw, make marks for the screws and screw the stop strip to the base plate. I slide the T-track back in, and finished is my circle cutting jig. Now it's time for a test cut. This jig works awesome. Easy to handle and cuts perfect circles. The first parts I cut with this jig are some sacrificial boards for my drill press. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click the notification bell and stay tuned for future projects. See ya!